starts in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Is fantastic.
Oh, sir, if I may suggest, the pheasant à la René. The sauce is one of the chef's most famous creations.
That sounds good. Anyway, just have a look. Take your time. By the way, I've got a bit of a dirty fork. Could you get me another one?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, it's nothing. I've just got a little bit of a dirty fork. Could you get me another one?
Oh! Sir, I do apologise.
Oh, no need to apologise. It doesn't worry me.
Oh, no, no, no! I do apologise! I will fetch the head waiter immediately.
Oh, please. It's only a tiny bit. You can hardly see it.
Oh, no, no! I am sure the head waiter, he will want to apologise to you himself. I will fetch him at once.
Well, you certainly get good service here, don't you?
They really look after you, yes.
Excuse me, monsieur and madame? It's filthy, Gaston! Find out who washed this up and give them their cards immediately!
Oh, no, no!
Better still, we cannot take any chances! Suck the entire washing up stuff immediately!
Oh no, I don't want to cause any fuss.
Please, it's no fuss. I quite simply wish to ensure that nothing interferes with your complete enjoyment of the meal.
I'm sure it won't. It was only a dirty fork.
And I'm sorry. I am bitterly sorry. But in fact, in our restaurant, you have been given a dirty, filthy, smelly piece of cutlery.
It wasn't smelly.
It was smelly and obscene and disgusting, and I hate it, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it. It's scrubby and dirty and stinky and all of those things.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, madam. I'm the manager. I've only just heard. May I sit down?
Yes, of course.
Do apologise humbly, deeply and sincerely about the fork.
Oh, please. It's only a tiny bit. You can hardly see it.
Oh, you're good, kind, fine people saying it. But I can see it. To me, it's like a mountain, a vast bowl of pus.
It's not as bad as that.
I can't give you any excuses for it. There are no excuses. I've been to spend more time in the restaurant recently, but I haven't been too well. Things aren't going well back there. The poor cook's son has been put away again, and poor Miss Dalrymple, who does the washing up, can hardly move her poor fingers. It's Gilberto's war wound. They're good people, and they're kind people. And together we'll begin to get over this dark patch. Now this. Now this.
Can I get you some water?
It's the end of the road!
You vicious, heartless. Look what you have done to him. He's grinded his fingers to the bone to make this place what it is. And you, with your feeble, petty quibbling, and you grind him to the dirt. This fine, honourable man whose boots you are not worthy to kiss. Oh, it makes me mad. Oh, so mad.
didn't say anything about the dirty knife.
And now for something completely different.
I'd like to have an argument, please.
Excuse me, sir. Have you been here before?
No, this is my first time.
I see. Well, do you want to have the full argument, or are you thinking of taking a course?
Well, what would be the cost?
It's £1 for a 5-minute argument, but only £8 for a course of 10.
I think it's probably best if I start with the one and go from there.
Mr. DeBake is free, but he's a bit agreeable. Oh yes, try Mr. Barnard, room 12.
Thank you. Is this the right room for an argument?
I've told you once.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have.
When?
Just now.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
You didn't.
I did.
You didn't.
I'm telling you, I did.
You're not.
Oh, I am sorry. Is this a 5-minute argument or the full half hour?
It's just a 5-minute one.
Just a 5 minutes? Thank you. Anyway, I did.
Most certainly did not.
Now let's get something quite clear. I most definitely told you.
No, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, look. This isn't an argument.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't. It's just contradiction.
No, it isn't.
It is.
It is not.
You just contradicted me.
No, I didn't.
You did just then.
Nonsense.
This is just futile.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. I came here for a good argument.
Ah! No, you didn't. You came here for an argument.
An argument isn't just contradiction.
Well, it can be.
No, it can't. An argument is a connected series of statements intended to establish a proposition.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. It isn't just contradiction.
Look, if I argue with you, I must take up a contrary position.
Yes, but it isn't just saying no, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
It isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't. Argument is an intellectual process. Contradiction is an automatic gainsaying of anything that the other person says.
It is not.
It is.
Not at all.
Yes, it is.
Thanks. That's it.
What?
That's it. Good morning.
But I was just getting interested.
I'm sorry, but the 5 minutes is up.
That was never 5 minutes just now.
I'm afraid it was.
No, it wasn't.
I'm sorry, I'm just not allowed to argue anymore.
What?
If you want me to continue arguing, you're just going to have to pay for another 5 minutes.
But that was never 5 minutes just now. Oh, come on. Oh, this is ridiculous.
I told you, I'm not allowed to argue unless you pay.
Oh, all right. There you are.
Thank you.
Well?
Well, what?
That was never 5 minutes just now.
I told you, I'm not allowed to argue unless you paid.
Well, I just paid.
You didn't.
I did.
You didn't.
I did.
You didn't.
I did.
You didn't.
I don't want to argue about it.
Well, I'm very sorry, but you didn't pay.
Aha! Well, if I didn't pay, why are you arguing? Aha! Gotcha.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have. If you're arguing, I must have paid.
Not necessarily. I could be arguing in my spare time.
Had enough of this.
No, you haven't.
Oh, shut up!
What do you mean, miss?
Oh, sorry, I have a cold. I wish to register a complaint.
Oh, sorry, we're closing for lunch.
Never mind that, my lad. I'm here to complain about this parrot that I bought only half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Ah, yes, Norwegian blue. What's wrong with it?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it, my lad. It's dead. That's what's wrong with it.
No, look, it's resting.
Look, my lad, I know a dead parrot when I see one, and I'm looking at it right now.
No, he's not dead. He's resting.
Resting?
Yeah, resting. Remarkable bird, the Norwegian blue, ain't it? Beautiful plumage.
The plumage don't enter into it. It's stone dead.
No, it's resting.
All right, if he's resting, then I'll wake him up. Hello, Polly! I got the big, nice, juicy cuttlefish if you wake up, Polly!
Look, he moved.
No, that was you hitting the cage.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. Hello, Polly! Wakey, wakey! This is your 9 o'clock alarm call! Now, that's what I call a dead parrot.
Nah, he's stunned.
Stunned?
Yeah, you stunned him just before he's waking up. Norwegian blue's done easily.
Right, my lad, I've had enough of this. That parrot is definitely deceased. And when I bought it, not half an hour ago, you assured me that its total lack of movement was due to it being tired and worn out after a prolonged squawk.
Well, it's pining from the fields.
Pining for the fields? What kind of talk is that? Look, why did it fall flat on its back as soon as I got it home?
Yeah. Norwegian blue prefers kipping on its back. Beautiful plumage.
I took the liberty of examining that bird and I realised the only reason it's still on its perch in the first place is because it had been nailed there.
Yeah, of course it was nailed there. If I hadn't nailed it there, it would have muscled up to the bars and vroom!
Look here, mate. This parrot wouldn't vroom if you put 4,000 volts through it. It's bleeding demise.
No, it's pining.
It's not pining. It's passed on. This parrot is no more. It has ceased to be. It has expired and gone to see its maker. This is a dead pat. It's a stiff. It ceased to exist. If you hadn't nailed it to the perch, it would be pushing up the daisies. It's run down the curtain and joined the choir invisible. This is an ex-parrot.
I'd better replace it then.
If you want to get anything done in this country, you have to complain till you're blue in the mouth.
Sorry, Squire, I've had a look. We're all out of parrots.
I see, I get the picture.
Got a sloth.
Does it talk?
Not really.
But it's scarcely a replacement then, is it?
Listen, I didn't want to work in a pet shop. I wanted to be a lumberjack.
I'm sorry, this is irrelevant, isn't it?
Yes! A lumberjack leaping from tree to tree as I walk down the mighty river of British Columbia.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night, I work all day.
And the potato king. Every potato knows me name because I'm the potato king.
Stop that! That's silly!
Very passable, this. Very passable.
Nothing like a good glass of Chateau de Castellier wine, eh, Gaziah?
You're right there, Obadiah.
Who'd have thought 30 years ago we'd be sitting here drinking Chateau de Castellier wine?
Aye, in them days we'd be glad to have the price of a cup of tea.
A cup of cold tea?
Without milk or sugar. Or tea!
In a filthy, cracked cup.
We never used our cup. We had to drink out of a rolled up newspaper.
The best we could manage was to suck on a piece of damp cloth.
Because, you know, we were happy in those days, even though we were poor.
Aye, because we were poor. My old dad used to say to me, money can't buy you happiness.
He was right. We were happier then, and we had nothing. We used to live in this tiny house with great big holes in the roof.
House? You were lucky to have a house. We used to live in one room, all 126 of us. No furniture, half the floor was missing. We were all huddled up together in one corner for fear of falling.
You were lucky to have a room. We used to live in a corridor.
We would have dreamed of living in a corridor. Would have been a palace to us. We used to live in an old tank on a rubbish tip. Woke up every morning with fish dumped on us. House.
Well, when I say house, it was just a hole in the ground covered by a piece of tarpaulin. But it was a house to us.
We were evicted from our hole in the ground. We had to go and live in a lake.
You were lucky to have a lake. There were 160 of us living in this tiny shoebox in the middle of the road.
Cardboard box?
Aye.
You were lucky. We lived 3 months in a brown paper bag in a septic tank. We used to have to get up at 6 o'clock every morning, clean the bag, eat a crust of stale bread, go down to work 14 hours a day, week in, week out. When we got home, our dad would have to thrash us to sleep with his belt.
Luxury. We used to have to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning, clean the lake, eat a handful of hot gravel, go to work at the mill every day for 2 pence a month, come home and Dad would beat us across the neck with a broken bottle, if we were lucky.
Well, we had it tough. We used to have to get up out of our shoebox at 12 o'clock at night, lick the road clean with our tongues, eat half a handful of freezing cold gravel, go to the mill, and work there for 24 hours a day and get a 4 pence every 6 years. And when we got home, our dad would slice us in two with a bread knife.
Right, I had to get up in the morning at 10 o'clock at night, half an hour before I went to bed. Drink a cup of sulfuric acid, work 29 hours a day down mill, and pay miller owner for permission to come to work. And when we go home, our dad and mother will kill us and dance about our graves singing hallelujah.
But if you try to tell the young people that now, they won't believe you. Nope.
No, nope. No, no, nope. No, no, no,
nope.
Some things in life are bad.
They can really make you mad.
Swear and curse
when you're chewing on life's whistle.
Give a whistle and this will help things turn out for the best.
And
always look on the bright side of life. There's something you've forgotten.
That's a laugh, a smile and dancing. When you're feeling in the dumps.
Don't be silly, chumps.
Get a Persian lick, a whistle, that's the thing.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Always look on the bright side
of life.
Come on, guys, cheer up.
Worst things happen at sea, you know.
And mean, what have you got to lose?
You know you come from nothing. You're going back to nothing.
What have you lost?
Nothing!
Nothing comes from nothing. Do you know what they say?
Cheer up, you old maggots. Come on, give us a grin.
Thank you.